So yeah, that was a 50,000 damage turn you just saw that wiped out an endgame red light level Topaz in 2 turns. So this is a showcase of a really fun glass cannon build that I've been mucking around with, that's built around the Voidranger Trampler's insane single target damage. Even against mechanical elites that are resistant to the aberrant type, we're still able to take out elites such as this gatekeeper here in a single turn with the rest of the team dead shortly after. So this team outputs so much damage that we can play it in one of two ways, either by taking out the largest threat on the field instantly to relieve pressure off your team, or as shown here to obliterate the weaker units to set up a numbers advantage. This allows you to slowly then bully the lone elite that's left standing. So the team is comprised of a Trotter that's going to be your sole healer. This healing is enough as you're not running this comp for prolonged battles, and the main reason why you're actually running this Trotter is to act as the primary debuffer, which I'll show you in a second once we get into the chips. Then we've got our Vagrant, which is really only here to drag our Voidranger to the front of the line. More turns means more damage. Our Silvermane Gunner is our sub DPS that works amazingly well with the Trampler. The Gunner's skill does quite a bit of damage and then does additional damage every time the enemy is attacked. Furthermore, his ultimate is a 300% attack damage nuke that gets an additional 100% boost based on how low the enemy's health is. Not only that, his talent lets him start off every fight with full energy, so talk about front loaded damage. Then we've got our main damage dealer of the crew here, the Voidranger Trampler, whose skill does a massive 300% attack damage along with a turn reset every time an enemy dies. Okay, so onto expansion chips. So the two main chips that you want on your Trotter is going to be the Parallel Enhancement, which causes a target to take 25% more damage after being hit for one turn, and then also the Wind Shear Loophole to apply a dot to the target. This dot is going to help trigger further damage boost on your other damage dealers. So the great thing about the Trotter is that it's going to be the fastest unit on this team, letting it go first to mark targets with its damage debuffs and dots. The other two slots can be whatever you want, really. I went with one that gave me 3 energy at the start so that I could do some basic healing right off the bat, just to ensure that my team stays alive for the first few turns. The Trotter patch is also great, but it's quite late game, so you can replace it with whatever you want. So my Vagrant has a pretty basic setup. I went with Morale Activation, which gives all allies damage increase, resistances, and speed whenever an ally attacks. Then I went with the Performance Allocation in the second slot, which gives 1 energy to all allies whenever an enemy is defeated. So this is a great snowball item as enemies start dying, allowing you to throw out more nukes. For my Silvermane Gunner, I had him equipped with the Malfunction chip, which has him deal an additional 50% of his attack to the enemy as long as they're debuffed. So this is where the Trotter comes into it, as that would be your main dot applicator. Then in my second slot, I just tossed on a basic 20% attack chip for a smidge more damage. And then for the Voidranger, I had him equipped with the High Load, Low Speed chip for that massive 90% attack boost. The speed reduction here doesn't really matter at all since you have your Vagrant to give your Ranger extra turns. That and all the extra bonus turns that you'll be getting makes this chip a best in slot for this unit. I then put on a Threshold Disruption chip, which increases an attack's damage by a massive 70% as long as the enemy's health is greater than 80%. So this is the reason why we're seeing those huge nuke numbers that's taking chunks off of elites and one-shotting regular enemies. Then in the final slot, I've got the Sudden Interjection chip, which gives you 1 extra turn for the first time that you use an attack, which just further ramps up that front loaded damage. And so that's the build. So you want to start off by applying dots and the damage increase debuff using your Trotter. Your Gunner then comes in and uses his skill on the main target to do additional damage when they're attacked. You then get your Vagrant, who comes in to drag your Ranger up to the front, who then unleashes 2 skills. If this kills something, then you get a 3rd turn. Then, you use your Gunner's ultimate to finish off whoever's low, all the while your energy for your team should be getting restored thanks to enemy deaths, which then gives everyone their ultimates for more shenanigans.